Hi, I'm Louise Pennington, the Professional Development Leader for Numicon at Oxford University Press. And today I'm going to run through a year three activity with you from Number Pattern and Calculating Teaching Resource Handbook 3, which focuses on multiplication and patterns within. So this activity is focusing on a word problem really, which is around buses in a bus station. Set it up for ease and for time. So here is bus route number one. So bus number one stops at every stop along the way, with the depot being zero. So if we use the green pegs for bus number two, which stops at every second stop, bus number three every third, bus number four every fourth stop. So here is, we're going to think about bus number two. He's going to stop at every second stop. So we're looking at he's going to stop on all the even numbers, so we're looking for children to notice this, that he's missing out the odd, stopping on the even. So his bus route would look like that. There we go. And so the other thing to think about is that the bus drivers need a rest stop. So if we think about bus number one, he's going to stop at every 10th stop, so he'll rest on the 10th and on the 20th. We've got to think about, can the children predict when bus number two will stop, stopping on every second stop? So his 10th stop will actually be stop number 20. So we can see there's some relationships going on here. And then so if we're taking bus number two as our example, stopping on every even numbered stop, every other one, and then think about the rest stops, we can start to think about the link between the two and the 10 times table. So if we use 100 square, so I've used the card track here to represent the 100 square, purely because I want to be able to see the numbers, I want to cover them up with counters or with pegs. So I've started to lay out the pattern here for bus route number two, stopping on every second stop. So we can see that all the numbers that end in 2, 4, 6, 8, 0 are the ones that he will stop on. We can predict on and fill it up to 100. And then these are the rest stops here. So we can see the link between the 2 times table and the 10 times table is that every time we get a multiple of 10, those are the rest stops. And every time we get a multiple of 2, those are the stops that the bus driver stops on. Then we can repeat this for the 3, 4, 5, 8, and 10 times table. We'll start to see some patterns and some common multiples coming up, really important. So this is about the link between the times tables that the children will be expected to know by this point. There is also a really lovely activity in the Explore More Copy Masters linked to this, which is called Frog Hop. And this is a game which focuses on the patterns in the 2 and 10 times table. And all you need for this is a dice with 1 to 6 spots or numbers on and 2 counters to play this game.